I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're going to be doing finger sandwiches today. And the finger sandwiches that we're going to do are deviled ham and cream cheese with chive on dark rye bread. So I'm going to get started by getting some bread out here. And I usually freeze this before I start doing this particular recipe. Because it's nice to have cold bread that is kind of hard so you can spread on top of it. The spreads that we're going to use are maybe crumbly or creamy and will not stick very readily to the surface of the bread unless you have it cold. Now that's not a necessity, it's just a suggestion. What I'm going to do with the bread is to bring it apart like this on a platter or something so that I know that it will go back together like this. And I'll be spreading one side with deviled ham and the matching side that will go up against it with the cream cheese with chives. Now, this is Underwood Deviled Ham. It's 4.25 ounces. I've actually opened a more generic brand that says ham spread, and it's about 5 ounces, 5.5 ounces. So either one of those would be fine. And then the cream cheese with chives, it's actually 1/3 reduced fat. It's 8 ounces, and I notice it says chive and onion. So you can substitute whatever works for you in terms of the amount of fat involved. Also, whether it's chive or if it's onion or if it's a combination of chive and onion. But it does need to have some good zesty flavor like that in order to go along with the spicy ham. All right, take a knife that you've been using, which I have already been using for the deviled ham. And come over and spread one of the inner sides. And as I said, it does tend to be a little crumbly and doesn't want to stick very well unless you have that good hard surface that will be provided by frozen bread. Frozen bread never freezes completely hard and it thaws out at room temperature very fast. So this is not going to be a lot different from thawed bread, and if you choose to do it with bread that has been thawed, that would be fine. So just spread a nice amount. You know that that's going to be one of your toppings or one of your fillings that goes inside the finger sandwich, and if you can get that even, that will be nice. It doesn't matter if you don't go all the way to the edges, we'll take care of those in a minute. So that's one side. The other side, I pick up a different knife, the one that I've been using for the cream cheese spread. So I get a generous amount, and remember, this is the side that's going to fit against that side, so I want to spread this side. And this is a little easier to spread. It will stick even if you have bread that is thawed. And my bread, I've had it sitting out, I did a few sandwiches earlier, and I've had it sitting out long enough that I can't tell much difference between this and thawed bread. So don't worry about that too much. And one more scoop here. And that about has it. Smooth it out. You want it pretty even, but don't worry about edges. So I'm just going to leave that. It's kind of messy looking, but I'm going to move over here. This plate, remember this was like this, and we flip it up so it matches perfectly. Now that's a big sandwich, and if you wanted to eat it as a sandwich, that would be fine. But our goal is to make some finger sandwiches, and the first thing to do, because this might be a formal type of reception or something, we're going to make them look pretty. And that means I'm going to trim off the four edges. I have an electric knife here, and that makes it a lot easier and quicker for me. If you just want to use a regular knife, that's fine. So excuse the noise, here it goes. You'll notice I took hardly anything off. It's just a matter of getting it nice and straight. That one was curved up a bit, so I took a little more off of that. And here I see that this is not very symmetrical, so I'm just going to line it up. Lining it up so that it has a straight edge. And one more. Just flip it around there so that you get all four sides. And as long as it looks nice, that's your goal, so you don't have to keep trimming down. But what you do at this point is make four fingers out of this. I would go to the middle and make one cut. If you start at the edge, you may have three thin ones and one thick one. But if you go to the middle, that ensures that you have two halves to work with, and then you're going to have those. And I'm letting this cut through to my old Pyrex dish here. I would advise you to be careful with anything that you're working with, and probably you're just using a regular knife, which is fine. And that's it for that sandwich. It's made four finger sandwiches, so let me add them to my collection. And what I have here is what I was working on earlier. You can see those nice fillings and the pretty look that it has with the dark brown rye bread. So let me try to arrange these a little bit better. Put a couple here on the top. And that's what you're going to serve your guests for finger sandwiches that are very tasty. The best part of them is that not only do they look good, but they taste great. Let me take a bite and see what is inside. You can see the edge there, and you see the layers. There's a creamy with a little bit, a dot here and there of green, and then there is the pinkish look of the deviled ham. This is my all-time favorite finger sandwich. I think you will really like this recipe.